obviously, from not only that video, but also his record. Larry Zbyszko, one of the world's most accomplished wrestlers. Now, as I understand it, you got into the martial arts form of self-defense long before it became a national fad.
Well, let me tell you something, and the people out there. I started Ishinru Karate back in 1968, and I used it help me develop my amateur background in terms of balance and in terms of different types of techniques to enhance my wrestling ability. I've incorporated in my style over the years, and that's what I rely on, my balance and quickness and some reflexes, because of this training, long before everybody wants to go out now and get into it or become a ninja. You know, I had my black belt in 1976.
All right. I understand all that. But what I want to talk about specifically now are these nunchucks, or noonchucks, as you call them. I saw a demonstration on 2020, not too long ago, and those things look like an awesome weapon to me. I brought a coconut. They set it up for me here in the studio. On 2020, they broke the coconut, and I would like to see you do that. I just want to get a close-up look at it.
You want to see me break the coconut?
I want to see you break the coconut.
With these.
Is that all right?
With
those.
Step aside for
you. All right. I'll go right around you and get way out of here.
Step aside. Let me see.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I'd seen it on film. That is awesome.
Yeah, what you have to realize is the coconut is hard. Everybody knows how hard it is. And it was absolutely nothing to smash a coconut in half with these pair of sticks. But what people have to realize is this is not a weapon. And a pistol is not a weapon. Human beings are the weapons, Larry. And these are only extension of our human nature. You know, I'm bringing my martial arts background into the open because I've noticed wrestling has become more brutal. We've got the road warriors in this business and some other people who go out of their way to make themselves fierce looking as a psychological warfare. We've got other people like Greg Gagne going through training camps and eating bugs and trying to change his attitude. We've got giants like Scott Hall, who were super strong individuals and young and aggressive and hungry. But what I want everybody to point out, this is my warning. If you can't beat me wrestling, and you're gonna go past the boundaries of the rules, Zbyszko's gonna be out there waiting for him. Because I know every dirty trick in the book and every form of technique from martial arts to wrestling.
Larry Zbyszko left everyone with the impression that nunchucks would never be used in the wrestling ring. In Atlantic City, New Jersey, Greg Gagne learned that was not the truth.
Wrestling fans, the following contest is the main event. It's the match you've been waiting for. Introducing in the ring from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing 236 pounds, he is the former America's champion, Larry Zbyszko. And wrestling fans, his opponent from Mound, Minnesota, weighing 218 pounds, Greg Gagne. And now down to Doug McLeod.
Uh-oh, now Larry Zbyszko going right out and making some threatening moves here as Greg Gagne starts to get ready to get in the ring. But I tell you, those nunchucks of his are a threatening-looking device, and it's a lethal weapon to the martial arts, and no question about it. And I'll tell you, Greg Gagne, I think very wisely, is just going to wait until referee Dick Worley. Wow, now here's what Greg Gagne is going to do. Wait, nothing. He's going to come in and he's going to get armed himself. Well, I'll tell you something. These two men have started right out in total combat here. And Nick Bockwinkel, earlier in this broadcast, earlier in this broadcast, you made a remark, in fact, right at the top of our program, about Greg Gagne's size and referred to him as the runt of the litter.
Well, at 218, 219 pounds, like Buck Zumhoff, that's not one of the big men. But then, you know, usually the runt of the litter is always the hardest fighting because you've got to in order to survive. Mr. Larry, of course, using the nunchucks, I'm sure, just because it's his personal hobby, and he trains with them, and like I said, uses them as training, and I'm sure if it can intimidate an opponent, that's what I'm sure he'd like to do.
Last week on In This Corner with Larry Zbyszko, you saw, I think, a very illuminating little feature on his use of them and what he's doing with them and training other people, and now they finally have got both these men ready to go.
Well, there's no question, they're a lethal weapon, but I mean, they have nothing to do with wrestling, so it's that simple.
Finally, now they're ready to go, but immediately referee Dick Worley is cautioning Greg Gagne about the use of that closed fist. And still, the two men have not yet come together.
Well, I'll say this right now. You're looking at probably two of the most excellent wrestlers in the world.
That's right.
It kills me to have to give the compliment to Greg Gagne. I've never been a favorite of the Gagne's, but his father was champion, and the son has learned well.
Oh, tremendous smash off the ropes. Sunset, there he goes. One, two. Whoa. Look at this.
Demonstrating really very quickly. I'm sure Larry's not too happy about what's taking place, but then Larry.
Oh, and a kick out by Gagne. These two men are going right at it, hammer and tongs, and now Gagne with a two count on Zbyszko.
It kills me to have to compliment Gagne, since he's not a favorite of mine, and especially since he's doing what he's doing against my own partner. But excellent exchange of moves, counter exchange. It's, to me, what makes part of the wrestling game so very exciting, because as you can see, I mean, these bodies are moving at 20 miles an hour faster, coming off those ropes, going back and forth, and the decisions have to be made with 220 pounds within a half split second.
Now Greg Gagne, Larry Zbyszko, Gagne up with a side headlock now, and Zbyszko off the ropes, look out. Well, boy, you never know. When a man comes off that ropes, you don't know what's gonna happen. There's a two, two and a half count on Zbyszko, and that shoulder came up again.
One of the hard things about doing commentary when it's your own partner that's in there against someone whom you don't care for is when he doesn't shine, I get a little bit stuck as to what I might say.
Well, I know it's gotta be hard to sit here and watch it in any event, and Greg Gagne now with the advantage on Larry Zbyszko, who goes for the hair. You can see it clearly there, but so can referee Dick Worley. No love lost between Worley and Larry Zbyszko in any event. We've seen matches here many times where they've got into it before.
Well, they say the referee's supposed to be totally unprejudiced, but one wonders.
Off the ropes, big smash, and down went Zbyszko. Oh, look at that! He caught Gagne's full stride there. There was an alert move because Zbyszko had to be a little bit staggered after that, but he caught Greg in full stride.
What happens at the last, very last second, Zbyszko was able to drop out of Gagne's sight. Gagne's bent over, it's like a tackle or like a football backfield man getting too far forward. He just had too much momentum going. He was planning on hitting Zbyszko, and when he couldn't get to him, he went right through the ropes. A little bit of a trip from Zbyszko and a little bit of a push. Gagne goes out to the floor, and with the force and the momentum that he was traveling, he probably hit that floor hard.
You can believe it, because Greg Gagne staggered at the side of the ring. And there you see Larry Zbyszko. Look out, Gagne. Whoa, he really nailed him with a knee that time. And he's not going to let Greg back in the ring.
No, not if he can help it. He's got him dazed. You drop that knee in on the apron, the man, he goes down. He's down, and he's down hurting him hard.
So Larry Zbyszko. Now Gagne's going to have to move fast. Another big smash from the knee of Zbyszko.
Into the shoulder, into the side of the neck and the head. These are when a guy's, there's a certain level when he's about a foot off the mat and you can drop a knee in, it almost gives you a perfect angle where you can hit him with maximum momentum.
Greg trying to get back in the ring. Referee Dick Worley trying to allow him to do so. And again, a big smash by Zbyszko.
Good forearm, right into the chest, right into the neck. A lot of people think you want to hit somebody in the side of the jaw. Well, that's good, but then that can be dangerous to you too. But if you hit him just below on the side of the neck and you hit the carotid artery, you can Charlie Horse that. You can completely just the back, the whole neck start, the side of the head just the same as a Sunday punch on the jaw.
Look at that! Gagne not gonna put up with that anymore. Now Greg Gagne with all guns firing, going to work, and Zbyszko smash to the turnbuckle.
Caught Larry, he's got him going.
Look at this now, Zbyszko off the ropes, up and over, and he was 15 feet high, folks. Flying drop kick by Gagne. And another one. And Zbyszko bails out.
Out onto the floor.
Now,
he's down completely, coming around.
Larry Zbyszko, no way to go.
Larry, you can't use the nunchuck.
Oh, right now, Nick Bockwinkel's going to try and get in the ring to get those nunchucks. Nick Bockwinkel is taking off the headphones, climbing in the ring, trying to get those nunchucks away from his partner, Larry Zbyszko. Now, wait a minute, Zbyszko, the smashing Gagne to the deck using those nunchucks. Bockwinkel trying to stop his partner. Zbyszko going absolutely wild. There goes the referee. Now Zbyszko has leveled his own partner, Nick Bockwinkel. He's leveled Gagne. He's leveled the referee, Dick Worley. And they're triumphant with the nunchucks in the middle of the ring. Now Bert Gagne climbing in there. Wait a minute. Here comes Bockzumov. Kurt Hennig. Wait a minute. Now everything going crazy at the side of the ring. The chains are getting thrown around, and it's absolute mayhem in the side of the ring. Unbelievable. Larry Zbyszko came down here to our broadcast position and took those nunchucks, which he had actually deposited with his partner, Nick Bockwinkel, and started flailing away. And you heard what Bockwinkel did. His reaction was to take off the headphones, jump in the ring, and now Bockwinkel is absolutely cold flat out on the canvas, leveled by his own partner, Larry Zbyszko. Bockwinkel went in to try to break it up, and his own partner cold cocked him with those nunchucks. And I'll tell you, something's gonna have to happen here pretty soon. Right at the side of the ring. Unbelievable. Greg Gagne being ministered to. He was first nailed right in the midsection with him, and then Zbyszko went to work on him. Now they're gonna have to help Gagne out of there. The doctor's in the ring now to have a look at Nick Bockwinkel. And Larry Zbyszko, folks, went absolutely hog wild crazy. I don't know, it's just like the man, something snapped. He got those nunchucks here from the side of the ring. And there you see his partner, Nick Bockwinkel, for heaven's sake, who was blasted to the deck just as Greg Gagne was. The referee, Dick Worley, the only one able to get back up again. Gagne being fireman's carried away from the ring by some of the other wrestlers, and the doctor now looking at Nick Bockwinkel. And Bockwinkel, you can see, really got it. Now here's what happened. Gagne with Zbyszko off the ropes. Up and over, and Gagne at this point clearly with the advantage. He was turning it on Zbyszko. Here's a series of flying drop kicks that really began to take the wind out of Larry Zbyszko. I think there were three at least. There were two for sure. Now watch. Bailing out of the arena, Zbyszko now comes out over. That's actually the bell table. You see Greg Gagne trying to get at him in the top of your screen, and there's Zbyszko. You see him take the nunchucks away from Nick Bockwinkel at ringside. We'll try to follow the action for you because it really got crazy at this point. Gagne got it in the midsection. Now you see Nick Bockwinkel off with the headphones, trying to get into the ring and subdue his own partner, Larry Zbyszko. Zbyszko cruising into those nunchucks on. Now you see what happened. But that's not the worst. Zbyszko blasts down Gagne. Bockwinkel still trying to restrain his partner, Larry Zbyszko. And now take a look at this. We try to follow the action. And Zbyszko turns on Bockwinkel, smashes him in the side of the head. It looked like he broke a piece off one of those nunchucks in so doing. There went the referee, Dick Worley. Absolutely incredible, and the only man left in the ring twirling that martial arts device, Larry Zbyszko. Unbelievable.